So I bought this bike and I have it in my apartment, and I thought I was gonna try and hang it somewhere else, but it didn't work out. So I decided this is the spot for the bike, kind of in between the fireplace and the kitchen area. And I want to have it up on the wall. So I started kind of looking at some different designs, and I decided that instead of just making a place to hang the bike, I would kind of make it a dual purpose thing. And what I'm actually gonna build here is a stall bar, like a Swedish stall bar workout system. And then as part of it, I'll build in the ability to do pull-ups and dips and use that same system to hang the bike. So I just wanted to show you kind of a little bit how I made it.
All right, so we'll start the design by drawing out the two 2x6s that we'll be using for the sides of the unit. From there, we'll go ahead and draw the top. This is also going to be a 2x6, and it'll be 29 inches long, which will cover the entire top of the unit. At the bottom here, we're going to draw again. This is actually going to be a 2x4, not a 2x6, and it'll be 26 inches wide because it'll be sitting in between the two 2x4s. What I'm drawing right now is I'm drawing the soffit that is right above where the unit will be, and what we'll actually screw into for some strength is that soffit, because the ceilings actually go even higher than the unit. Next, we'll draw the bars themselves, and those we're actually going to be using 3/4 inch black pipe for. You can see the unit is going to be 8 feet high. The reason for that is that's the height of the soffit, as well as that's a very standard height, so if I move this to another apartment or house, it should be able to fit anywhere. And it'll be 29 inches long, or wide, I'm sorry. 2x6s are actually 5.5 inches wide, so that's how wide. This is a side view I'm drawing for you. And now I'm drawing the center of the hole for drilling. Those centers are going to be 6 inches apart. And then off the front of the unit will actually go 7/8 of an inch. From there, now that we found the center of each hole for each dowel, we'll drill the holes, and those holes will be 1/8 of an inch wide. And the reason why is because we're going to be using that 3/4 inch black pipe, which is actually an inch wide.
Now, I want the bike to sit in perfectly even between here and here.
So just to start off the design and the drawing, what I'm going to do is on the right-hand side, I'm going to quickly draw a window, nothing special, and just label it window. And then after I'm done with that, on the left-hand side here, I'm just going to draw the fireplace. So that's just the fireplace there, and here's my mantle. And I'm sorry this is off the screen just a little bit, but I'll bring it back into focus. After that, I'm just going to draw that the distance between the fireplace and the window is, for me, 75 inches.
You have to find the center weight of your bike. So you can think that it's here, but you can see that just slopes up the front of the bike. So you kind of have to play around. So my bike right here is about dead center. So you just kind of have to find it for your specific bike. And then
I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to note 4 inches on each side. And the reason why is because for my specific bike, it's 67 inches long. And 75 minus 67 is 8 inches. And 8 divided by 2 is 4. So it's gonna be 4 inches off. And now you can see me draw the bicycle with my extremely round wheels because I'm such a great artist. And there you go. Now you've got your little road bike in the middle just for reference in the image. At the bottom here off the screen, I'm just gonna note that the bike is 67 inches wide. And next what we're gonna do is I'm gonna draw a line on the bike, just noting where the center of weight is. This is not the center of the bike, it's the center of weight. And I'm just noting center of weight. And now for me, if I draw from the center of weight and I measure from that point to the back of the bike, it is actually 32 inches. So 32 plus the 4 inches off the back to the window is 36, and that'll be the center of my unit. The tools and supplies that you'll need for this job, I went to the hardware store and I bought 1 2x6x8, 1 2x6x12, and 1 2x4. If you don't have all the saws that I have, you may want to have them cut as much of the wood for you at the store before you leave. I also designed the unit to be 29 inches wide so that when I bought the 3/4 inch black pipe that comes in 10 foot lengths, it would equally divide into 30 inch pieces. And they threaded that for me there at the store. Other things you'll need is a tape measure. You'll need a square. I really like this adjustable one. You'll need 2.5 inch wood screws. You'll need a level. drill bits, a jigsaw, 1 1/8 inch spade drill bit, a drill. That is shelving traction paper, shims. You also may need a circular saw, and you might need some of those clamps.
So I wasn't able to record a ton of the build for you, but I'm just going to kind of go over what I did do to get to this point. We got the camera here. All right, so the first thing we did is had all the wood cut. Then I marked the center of every single one of these holes and drilled them all with the spade bit. You can see it's a rough cut with that spade bit, and it kind of chips up just a little bit. Honestly, I would come back with a sander and get these really nice if that's what you want. The next thing we did is down at the bottom here, you can see, use that jigsaw to jigsaw out around the molding. So if you have molding, that's why you'll need the jigsaw. If you don't have molding for some reason, then you actually would not need the jigsaw for this. The next thing that we did is up at the top here, I pre-drilled some holes in that 29-inch header and screwed those down into the side pieces there and there. Then before I put the bottom in, I brought this into its position and screwed it up into the soffit. And you can see I've got a few screws, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws in there. Next, what we did is we brought that down to the very bottom. And what we did is the top was secure. I took the 2x4, and you can see the reason why we use the 2x4 over the 2x6 is with this molding and this molding, it kind of pushes out, but in the end, it actually lines up just perfectly. So that's why we went with the 2x4 down here. What you can't really see is that at the bottom here, you have that shelf traction liner shoved in underneath here for traction and to protect the floor. Then what I did is we took the shims and I shimmed in underneath here, and you can kind of see there's some space underneath there. So basically, you can kind of see here, I just put some shims under there, used another 2x4, and then I just hammered on the end of this and got that super tight up into there. I also did the exact same thing on the other side, and then I tested to make sure that it was nice and solid, which it was. At that point, I laid down the traction material underneath the 2x4, put the 2x4 in place, then I kneeled on the 2x4, came around here, and while I had as much weight as I possibly could get on the 2x4, I put in these two screws here on both sides. So then after that, I made sure it was secure, and I pulled those back out. So now we have the 2x4 at the bottom, and that's jammed in. So basically, the only thing that's holding this into place is the pressure pressing down on the floor and a couple of screws at the top. So the only reason why I actually did the design that I did do as far as the way that I secured it to the floor and the ceiling is just because this is a brick wall and I didn't really feel like drilling into it and dealing with that hassle. If in the future it gives me any problems, I can always come back and secure it and make it a lot more secure. For you, if you're doing this in a normal house, on a normal wall, and you can find studs, especially wood studs, I definitely recommend screwing this into the studs. So that's pretty much how I got the stall bar, Swedish wall bar thing installed. Join me in the next video and I'll show you how I made the part to actually do the pull-ups, dips, and hang the bicycle.